Yeah, we got gray skies. We had rain. Not a heavy rain, but it was at 4 degrees. And when you get a wind blowing, it makes it feel cooler, especially if you get wet. You think it's even colder. Today I got my, let me fix the zoom here. And as you can see, the tide is going out. Another hour, I should be able to get on to Paradise and Front Ravines. Well, I'm kind of hoping to find something today. I'm sure there's something. There's always something on this beach. I have to pull this in back. There. There's 2 to 3 feet of fresh stuff on this beach. And if I had to rake, I would probably be able to rake it up, and I would probably, that rake would kick up something. I know it would. But I don't have a rake with me today, so I'm just going to play it by eye. No, it's limestone. Oh my God, it isn't even that. That is a piece of worn concrete. That's all that is. Just a piece of worn concrete. Jeez, I saw it. Oh my God, could that be a coral? No, piece of worn concrete. Well, that's igneous stone. What's this? Oh, there's a very old piece of pottery. I can't even date this. I don't know when it was made. But I'm sure, may the spirit of the people who use this rest in peace. That's more igneous stone. Well, of course, the eroded field of Mount Simpson from 400 million years ago covers most of southwestern New Brunswick. So naturally, during the ice ages, a lot of that eroded material ended up in the Bay of Fundy. That's why I'm finding all that material here on the beach. But if you augered a hole in this, you could probably, I don't know, kind of big to hang on a zipper to make a zipper easier. Okay. There's a stone. This piece of granite. I have to get the... Now, that's a piece of granite. Here's another piece of pottery. Interesting. I should have brought the trowel. I could have been digging through it with the trowel and stirring things up. So I will use my boot. And today I've got my military rain suit on, mostly as a windbreaker. It's not 100% rainproof. It has to be sprayed down good to make it totally waterproof again. But I wear it, like to wear it as a windbreaker. Rain gear can also keep you warm in single-digit temperatures. Sometimes you have to do that to see what's under the surface. That is porcelain. It's actually, might make a nice pendant. I have to let the camera focus on this. Come on. Oh, for the love of God. Oh, that's a nice piece of granite here. If you tumbled this, you've shown it up really good and shaped it into fancy shapes, you could call it fancy jasper. But there's another name for it. Only Lindsay Meadows or others would know. I have to put my mitts on. My fingers got wet. The crazy wind is, this wind is kind of raw and wet fingers, so I better keep my fingers warm. Has a rake, so I'm gonna have to. I will just take the rock. Out. Part of some Devonian reef, I don't know. The only points you would be able to nap off of are small ones. Of material. That's nothing to get excited over as far as fossils go. Little beads. No pearl, no coral fossils. I think it's around 3 degrees or 2 degrees right now. And the way the wind is blowing, it makes it feel cooler. So it's two more. one for a parka. But too cold for a spring coat. And there isn't much mud laid down anymore. That's a good sign. That is a very good sign. No mud. I had to take that round thing off the bottom of the pole so I could get into the seaweed better. I think in the summer when I hit the woods, I'll put that round thing back on. Right there, there's that little yellow speck you see. There you go. Yeah, that's a little yellow speck. It used to be part of a pearl, but it got broken up. Right there. Yeah, that is a little piece of carbon. I wish I could have found that pearl before the tides and the beach broke it up. That would have been nice. I don't really do anything with the pearls anyway. There's nowhere to sell them. I've made an ivory cross for the life and put some pearls on that. But all the rest, the majority, 90% of all the pearls went to the school. And then the next half hour, I will be able to get to the truck ravines. I'll do the smart thing and go take a walk down over the mud flat, see what's there. and there's no mud. There's sand, natural sand, but there's no mud. That is a good sign. Oh my God, there's a pearl. A green pearl. It is center picture. There we go. Oh, that water is cold. Find. Finally. Come on, camera focus, holy cow. That's a pearl. I was finally rewarded with a pearl. I'm very happy, that just made my week. That's what the mud was hiding yesterday and the day before. Wow. Okay, come on. You just have to get access to my pocket so I can put the pearl in it securely. There. That was a nice pearl. Since I saw the dredger right there, I was really hoping to find a pearl because I knew the dredger. This one's that. Because I knew the dredger was stirring up the bottom of the shipping channel in Courtney Bay. I knew something would come up. I hope that there's another pearl or two kicking around up there. That would be nice. It is not raining, but the air is still really, really, really damp, and the wind is blowing a little bit. See that yellow speck? That is a sliver of carbon off a pearl. It's that center picture right now. Yeah, okay. That one holds. that was a leftover from a furl that was stuck out here for a long time, and it finally broke up. It's been an interesting little walk so far. One pearl. That makes it a well worth walk. A well worth it walk. And somewhere on this beach is another pearl. Somewhere under this sand. Somewhere under the seaweed.